This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Hey guys, salut, this is Alex, welcome back to the Croissant series. In this episode, I'm gonna build a brand new version of my dough sheeter. And there are two reasons for this. So reason number one, that tool is possibly the most important tool when you're making croissant dough, apart of course from the oven, which might be the first one, or the fridge, which might be the second one. So it would be the third most important tool. What do you want? And the second reason, which is a bit more sad, the previous dough sheeter machine that I built in episode 4 of the croissant series has been damaged. It's basically f***ed up. During studio renovation, it's been shaken, it's been moved, it's not working properly anymore, and that's not only bad, to be honest. Since this machine had quite a few problems in the first place, I did struggle a lot inserting those axes in the center of the rolling pins, and now it makes the precision completely not precise. There is way too much friction. Also, this machine is just too big. It's just using this spot. I could make it more compact, but then the other problem would just remain the same, so no. So as I recently got myself a 3D printer, I thought maybe I could use that to my advantage. So I made a 3D model of a first design. Let me show it to you. So I kept a few things from the previous design. I kept the gears, I also kept the rotating thickness adjustment system, but I changed the moving tray mechanism. I'm not using a wire anymore, I'm just using racks and pinions. Now, obviously, a new design also comes with new problems. First of all, the curve right there is not accurate. Also, it's based on axes, which means that I need to insert them perfectly perpendicular. But these are just tiny problems regarding this. That bar is here to make sure that those two driving gears will move synchronously and will make the tray move back and forth in an efficient, smooth, and parallel manner. It also comes with the dumbest mistake ever. This bar is totally in the way. The dough can't get to the rolling pin unless it's flatter than 9.2 millimeters. I made a flattening machine that only accepts already flattened dough. I'm gonna address these problems, but one by one. The rolling pin itself, it's not a rolling pin in the first place. It's a table leg, which I went for just because of its amazing diameter. Problem is, it is wobbly on itself. Like, there is at least a 2-3 millimeters variations in height. When you're working with a 4 millimeter dough, it just makes like for 50% accuracy. So instead of going for a complicated solution like buying a lathe, turning myself perfectly round, I'm gonna use a rolling pin. I had this one for a while in my studio. It's perfectly round and perfectly straight. Of course, it's promising if I can manage to connect this perfectly perpendicularly to my machine. I got something. So this is the part that I just designed. So it connects to the rolling pin like so, which means that it's automatically and perfectly centered. Then it's gonna be secured using 4 screws right there. That's great, because instead of transmitting the torque to the axis, I'm gonna directly transmit it to the gear. And that's great news, but it also means that I need to do another design, because this would definitely not fit in what you just saw. So let's start again. Skillshare is an online learning community with over 25,000 classes in cooking, design, business, you name them. If you want to fuel your creativity, your thirst for more knowledge, then Skillshare is the perfect place for that. I'm following 2 classes at the moment, one about brewing my own beer and the second one about, obviously, 3D modeling. Skillshare is pretty affordable, as the annual subscription for the premium membership is less than $10 a month. So if you want to join more than 7 million creators learning with the Skillshare, well, the first 500 of my subscribers to use the link in the description box down below will get 2 month free trial. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. Truth is, I've been working on a new design. Hopefully it's much better. Let me run you through it and then I'll just assemble all the parts. So overall it's more compact, I'm making good use of the gears you just saw, there's a driving axis which is not in the way anymore and that's good, and the tray is now on top of the driving pinion and that's great. So to adjust the thickness, it works the same, you spin the whole arm like this, and to set it in place, basically you use a little pin that just blocks the system in one setting. Now those two pieces are connected, like when the tray is moving, then the gears are spinning. They can't move without one another. So I guess I got everything I need. I'm gonna print all these parts of my 3D printer. Okay, let's do this. Looks very promising. Looks solid, it feels solid. Let's give it a try with the bearings. I need plywood, lots of plywood. I think I got all the parts that I need to build at least like a proof of concept. Side arm, driving gear, rolling pin gear, X-bolt that just seals the whole thing. Way! This is very exciting. You've got this part, which is very important. It's a rack. And so when I turn this... The worst engineer ever. Let me show you why I'm saying... So when the tray moves forward, basically this is spinning clockwise and it should be spinning counterclockwise in order to suck the dough in, not to just... If I were to add another gear in inside just to reverse rotation of this big gear, then I would increase the friction. If I were just to place the tray underneath when the big rolling pin gear goes down, it would crush the rack used with the pinion to make the tray move. Okay, I got a solution. Let's stop everything for the day. Let's just have a break, okay? Let's call it a day. And see tomorrow what I think of this. Okay, we'll see us in the morning. Well, I think I got something. I think I'm gonna put the tray underneath the driving gear. And I know I mentioned that the big rolling pin gear was gonna crush the rack if I were to do this. Well, let me introduce you to what I call the bobbin gear. It's very similar to the first rolling pin gear that I made earlier, but now you've got a groove right there. And that groove just allows you not to crush the rack and yet to be connected properly to the rolling pin and to flatten that dough. I think this is the key to my machine. Let me just print a few more parts, do a little sewing action, put everything back together, and then hopefully we should get a machine. Wish me luck. Tense moment. I'm just putting the final screws to my contraption, hoping everything will run smoothly. Okay, back to it. And forth. Back
forth!
So I would say that compared to my previous machine, it's so much of an improvement. It's so compact. I love how accurate the new settings are. And also it's just more obvious, there is less friction, it's more efficient. And it's probably like a 20th of the original size. A 20th! 20th. I just gave it a test with some proper dough and I'm really, really pleased with the result so far. It's really accurate. I mean, it really does the job and it's so compact. So I guess this is another step on completing the perfect ultimate French croissant. By the way, I will share all the files with you in the description box down below. I'm gonna give this machine a proper use on another dish, something I've been working on for quite a while. It's not a croissant, it's something else. So guys, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I hope you enjoyed this machine. Give it a like, share, spread, sub. You know what you gotta do. Take care, bye bye. Salut.